Hello, it's me again. Welcome to my channel. I wanted to comment today on something which I saw online. It is so-called Havana Syndrome. And I would like to elucidate on that based on research from electromagnetic in physiology and medicine. First of all, a couple of days ago, I discovered one very inspiring video by Sabine, who was trying to explain what is actually 5G and what is microwave radiation and whether we could have some harm on that. But I would like to add some knowledge coming from physiology that I have, because I dealt basically all my career with electromagnetic stimulation in medicine, specializing on transcranial magnetic stimulation, transcranial direct stimulation, basically all kind of electrical and electromagnetic stimulation of brain and human tissues. So let's begin. First of all, what is Havana syndrome? You can find below the link to the conversation article stating that US authorities was actually worried about some unorthodox kind of weapon which are causing people to have some very strange symptoms which are untractable. They reportedly have headaches, some nausea, some like kind of visual hallucinations, but none of that can be traced down to some physical or physiological cause. So what that might be? Why it is called Havana syndrome? Because also reportedly, and I learned from old press and articles which were public back then, that in some period while US had embassy at Cuba, which was collaborating with Russia and Russia scientists, their employees and embassy seemed to have untraceable problems with nausea, very untraceable headaches which are unstoppable, etc., etc. And it said in those literature that some of those people had that kind of disorder for life. So they couldn't find anything. They scanned them, they examined them. The best physiologists and neurologists and other doctors examined them, and they could find nothing. But knowing what we know now, we can maybe try to explain what that might be. First of all, I would like to recall what Sabina explained in her video, which is down below, that you have the whole spectrum of electromagnetic radiation, and more or less you are used to it. One particular frequency and wavelength, which is between 1 and 10 millimeters, and this is upper bound of microwave radiation, is very well known. Basically, we are using that in our microwaves, and in 5G networks it is used for higher band of frequencies to communicate better the signal. So can it cause the harm? How we can actually realize what is the real danger of it? First of all, let's get back to a microwave that you probably use every day to heat your food, to even cook something. The thing is that microwave radiation is acting upon molecules of water in your food. They are actually causing them to increase the temperature, and this is how that liquid food or something which you are going to eat gets hotter and hotter. One of the feelings reported by victims of this Havana syndrome was that they had immediate feeling of hotness in their skin, in their face, and they had to step down. And I read also in that conversation piece that someone who is expert for secret weapons in the US actually reported that they experimented with focused beam, those characteristics, and the feeling is that you are really hot. I read the explanation from someone who is present that he had an expression like somebody opened the oven just in front of his face, and he really need to step back because it was so hot he couldn't, he had the impression that he is going to get burned. The thing might be that that kind of radiation is actually heating something which is below your skin, and it can maybe cause some damage of the skin and burns. But what that can be, although we cannot trace that something is going on, except that you feel that the temperature is rising and that you feel unpleasant, there are multiple devices that we can measure that a kind of that field exists in the space. And what is more, you can easily trace back what is the source. This is one. Second, as Devra Davis elaborated on the use of mobile phones and the health adverse effects it can have on us, basically boils down to the effect that that kind of radiation can raise the temperature of the tissue. So what is wrong with that? Our tissues are mainly built on proteins and other long molecules and a lot of water, meaning that if something is about to damage that tissue, it has to have a mechanism to make it hotter and hotter, because as you know, when you're cooking the food, when you're cooking the egg, and when you're cooking the meat or something like that, it needs to be above certain temperatures so it is totally cooked. Meaning that if you increase the temperature in the tissue above certain level, it is damaging. How do I know that? I know that because I've worked with electromagnetic stimulation. And if you use electromagnetic stimulation, for example, in medicine, to stimulate a muscle or to stimulate a tissue, there are very strict standardized ways how you're measuring that and how you're testing for the potential risks. Otherwise, the device couldn't be certified and it couldn't be in use, especially in medicine. For example, if you're applying transcranial magnetic stimulation, transcranial means through crania, through the skull, and that magnetic field induces a weak electrical field in the cortex, in the surface of your brain, and stimulates certain centers. So before that was approved to be safe, certain tests were performed in order to find out what is the transfer of energy that that particular kind of electromagnetic stimulation is actually transferring to the tissue. And very long we know for a limit, which is 1 degree centigrade, meaning that it is upper bound. If electromagnetic stimulation is transferring energy to the tissue, which is increasing its temperature, overall temperature, for 1 degree centigrade, it is already damaging. So every electromagnetic stimulation for every device used in medicine, in cosmetology, elsewhere, has to be way down below that limit, so much less than 1 degree centigrade. And I'm sure that even when you're certifying devices like mobile phones and things like that, somebody has to perform that kind of research, because there is the procedure for certification, CE mark, and approval for the market. Then beside that, I know, I'm aware that before NASA sent astronauts in space, and before Russians actually entered in space projects, they ran a lot of research about all kind of electromagnetic influences on human organism, and there are a lot of documents about that. For example, If you're using any kind of electromagnetic field, you should test how increase of certain frequencies or decrease of frequencies, then the change of power which is transferred to the tissue, and the phase actually affects certain organ or tissue or organ in whole. I want to point to one very underrepresented problem here, because due to the Cold War and this kind of communication and talk about secret weapons and use in that kind of weapons to actually damage somebody's, to actually affect somebody's health, reminds me of that talk which is used in Cold War. Before that, when the crisis in nuclear weapons, in nuclear war was much more real, the focus of the connection between those weapons and general health are on ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation is much more dangerous, and they were much more reporting on that. But there is very little reporting of electromagnetic pollution. I don't know whether many people know for that term, but we are actually living in the cities, and we are surrounded by all the devices which are producing actually electromagnetic radiation on different scales, and nobody is talking about that. Devra Davis and her team is one of the rare scientists who is actually drawing your attention on that. For example, when we are talking even of any device which is very close to you, why that can be dangerous? Because the whole physiological, all the physiological systems that are running in our body, their signaling is partially chemical, partially electrical. So if you're looking on the level of voltages that can be measured on every member of every single cell in your body, it is of level of microvolt. Micro means 1 millionth part of the volt. And also, when you record electroencephalogram, this is electrical signal generated from your brain, again, this is in microvolts. What does that mean? That means if you're generating those signals, which have different kind of purposes, but part of that is signaling and in how our neurons are functioning, how the messages are sent, how the regulation is done in a very complex physiology that we have. If you have a signal which is on the same level, on the same amplitude, the same frequency, then it can disturb the original signal. So my opinion is that humans are made to live in some sort of influence of electromagnetic magnetic radiation, but if the amplitude and frequency is very similar to your in internal sources, there is a great risk of disruption. Meaning that if you spend a lot of time in that field, which is producing the similar signals, signals of the same level of strength like your body is producing, some sort of miscommunication can happen. We don't know about that. There are not a lot of research in that area, because the research in electromagnetic stimulation for brain and other tissues was done way back in 80s, 90s, and before that. But at the moment, it is not so popular subject of research, and people cannot get funding for that. And I can actually summarize that we should pay more attention to electromagnetic stimulation which is around us. For example, if you're using your phone, your mobile phone, I mean, a lot of people are afraid that they can disrupt how your body is functioning. And as Sabine pointed out, we simply don't know, because there are not enough research on that. But think of this. If you're constantly wearing your mobile phone, for example, on your chest, in the pocket of your shirt, or in your back pocket on your trousers, and that telephone is constantly communicating with our, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, you're basically affected by that all day long. And if that kind of signal is present all the time, it can increase the temperature of that part, and maybe there are some source to worry, some reasons to worry about that. There is some research based on increased temperature of parts of the face, part of the chest, and actually parts of the body that were done. I will put the link below, which says that we shouldn't be holding our telephones close to our skins for long period of time, or at least if we do, we should switch it on airplane mode. That I agree with Sabine that I can understand that a lot of people are worried about innovations, but the only cure for that is to really find out about the effects. And I think that we need to perform more research on this. That would be enough for today. See you next video.